Die film Meerkat Maantuig het groot opspraak gemaakt bij verlede jaar se Silverskermfees voor sy unieke kunsthuisagtige stijl, wat volgens kritici nog niet van tevore op Suid-Afrikaanse skerms gesien is nie. Kom ons kyk.
Vloek gaan my kry. Vloek gaan my nie kry.
Wat maak julle?
Ons bou vir Bobesie 'n maantuig. Een meerkat maantuig.
Anshin Du Plessis en Themba Ntuli is hier om vir ons meer te vertel oor die ervaring. Welkom julle. Anshin, ons begin by jou. Vertel ons, hoe het dit gebeur dat jy die rol in die fliek gekry het?
Ek is by agentskap, Talent ETC, so hulle het vir my e-mail gestuur en ek het gegaan vir die audisie. Maar ek het nie oorspronkelijk die rol gekry nie. Die meisie wat eerst die rol gekry het, geloof het of nie, is actually aangeval deur 'n leeu. Ja, dis nogal, ja. Wow. Dis sy lewe nog, maar... Ja, maar dit het gebeur een week voordat hulle moes begin skiet. So toe moes hulle nou vir Gideon net recast. En Hanneke bel toe en sy sê toe, ek moet kom vir 'n audisie. En toe direct daarna, toe sy vir ons ook 'n maker die rol gekry.
So, yeah. This is a story. And Themba, how did you get into the film?
Just like Anshin said right now, it's all about an audition process. And I think for me it was... Again, just God's grace, because I had not known, and I've never been in the Afrikaans community and ever acted, you know, in Afrikaans based film. And then I remember when Dries told me that there's a film that they're casting for, and I met with Anshin and I met with Hanneke, and I auditioned for Bobesie, and I guess here I am.
The rest is history. Anshin, hoe balanceer jy jou verantwoordelikhede by die skool en jou loopbaan?
Ek het met Meerkat Maandag het ek 5 weke skool gemis, wat nogal rof was. Ja. So toe ek teruggekom het, was het gelukkig in die vakantie gewees. So ek moes my eksamens wat ek gemis het inhaal en ek moes boekwerk en klaswerk inhaal en ek moes ekstra klasse kry. So dit was nogal rof. Maar ja, ek verruil die geleentheid wat ek gekry het vir niks in die wêreld nie.
Themba, you are actually turning 28 years old this year, and the character that you play in the film is 10 years old. Tell me a little bit more about your career playing these younger roles.
Sure, waar begin
ek? Hoeveel tyd het ons?
Yeah, ons het nie baie tyd. I'll keep it very short, like myself, all right? So I basically started acting when I was 16 years old, and I was still doing grade 10, and just like Anshin, I was still in school, and I had to juggle between school and acting. Now, the fortunate thing is that because I look so small and I look young, you know, I look younger than my age, you know, am I right?
Yes, definitely.
And so, you know, when I started this whole acting thing, I never figured that I would be playing a lot of child roles. But now I'll tell you one thing, that it started becoming a little bit more challenging the older I grew, you know, because the mindset obviously changes over time. From when I was 16 to now 27, going to 28, you know, it was a transition that I had to make, and I constantly had to keep studying like little kids and, you know, just getting to understand what goes through their minds, through 10-year-olds, you know, through 11-year-olds. And obviously, even with my younger brothers, at the time, I could still mimic them and kind of see what they're doing. But now everyone is sort of growing up, so I have to keep my mind young. But I mean, I'll tell you one thing. I'm a very youthful person, and I believe that God has given me such a young spirit that I'm able to just tap into it and be like so young and like, hey, what do you want me to do? Do you want me to just like lie around and jump up and down? And I'm always excited by that challenge.
Yeah.
But I'm also eager and excited to do roles that cater to my age, roles that have a certain maturity to them, where people would look at me and be like, yo, okay, he looks short, but I think what he just did is like very old, you know? So I also look forward to roles like that. And it's just an interesting journey looking into a young person and saying, okay, Themba, forget about yourself.
Yeah.
All right, it's not about you. You are Bobesie. You're a young kid. Explore. If you need to like, do your own stance, which I did half some of the time, you know, lying down, upside down. I did all of that. And it just keeps you young.
Yeah. You're speaking about young actors. There are a few older actors in this piece that you guys have really learned from. So you let me Pierre van Pletsen and Rika Senet gewerk. What was that experience like?
Sure, ek dink ons kan altyd sê ons het regtig baie geleer. Oom Pierre het, hy is al baie lank in die industrie. So hy het ons wel vir my veral het hy gehelp met die goed waarmee ek gesukkel het en hy het my raad gegee en vir my gesê hoorie, maar ek doen iets so doen, jy dit probeer dit so doen. So het my baie gehelp met die goed, ja.
Yeah. I think for me, you know, the beautiful thing about Wimpied is that when you see veterans just keep going and keep going and keep going without losing heart, obviously every now and again they sort of had to sit down and rest because of old age, you know. But I can tell, no, like, you know, I'm not saying like he's old, but like, hey, you know, but with all due respect, I really believe that he's got such a heart for what he's doing. Yeah. And you can tell that it's not just a fly-by-night thing.
Yes.
Many people get into this thing because of fame, because of now social media and likes and all of that. But he's been doing it because it's something that he fell in love with.
Yes.
You know, and over the time that he has spent in his career, he's just able to teach, even if he doesn't say anything, even if he doesn't say to you, okay, probeer doen het so of doen het so. But, you know, he'll just do something. You look at it and you'll be like, ah,
yeah.
He's kept it very simple, even when I'm trying to be a bit over the top. So you just look at different reactions and you see that, that's what I can try, that's what I can do, yeah.
And Jeanette, baie gou ten slotte, hoekom het mense Meerkat Maandag gaan kyk?
Meerkat Maandag het 'n ongelooflike mooi boodskap wat het uitlever. Die boodskap van die fliek is basies dat jy oor jou vrese moet kom en dat jy nie jou lewe in vrees moet lewe nie. En ek dink mense kan maklik konnekteer met die karakters. So elkeen kan hulle self sien maar plaas in Bobesi of in Gideonet. So hulle kan maklik hulle self vind sien maar in die fliek, ja.
Baie dankie julle twee. Dit is wonderlik om julle hier te hê.
Baie dankie vir die tyd.
Dit was Anjan Du Plessis en Themba Ntuli van die film Meerkat Maandag. Onthou, dit begin môre in fliekteaters draai. So maak 'n plan om dit hierdie naweek te ondersteun.